Welcome. In today's video, we're going to be looking at how to set up a Word document in an accessible format. Following these practices will help ensure our document complies with accessibility standards. There are 8 topics we're going to review. Check the description for each of the topics and their corresponding timestamp if you wish to skip ahead. The topics we're covering are headings, alternative text for images, lists, columns, tables, descriptive hyperlinks, accessibility checker, and exporting to PDF. I have created this Word document that you can see here. Microsoft Word is fairly flexible in formatting, so to myself, this document might look okay. However, I have formatted this in a way that any screen reader will have a difficult time conveying the information accurately. So let's fix the document together. When headings are formatted correctly, they are tagged as headings in the metadata of the document. This allows a screen reader to skip back and forth between the headings with a keyboard command. These current headings are just bolded, so they are not tagged in the metadata. To fix this, select the Home tab, highlight the text, and click on the appropriate heading level from the Styles box. Branches of Government would be Heading 1. Executive would then be Heading 2. Legislative is also Heading 2, and the Senate and House are Heading 3, since they are sub-parts of the legislative branch. To edit the style of a heading, right-click the heading in the Styles box and then select Modify. Alternative text is important for images. A screen reader will not be able to identify what it is an image of if there is no alt text set. After you insert an image, right-click and select Format Picture. Select Layout and Properties, choose Alt Text, and type in the text which in this example would be President Abraham Lincoln. As a note, you don't have to type, "This is a picture of," etc. Use the description field, not the title field, as that is what the screen reader is going to be looking for. Close the format picture window when finished. In addition, if your image contains text within itself, you must set the alt text to match the text in the picture. Lists are similar to headings. They're tagged in the metadata of the document, so screen readers are able to interpret the information accurately. This list we're looking at was created by using the hyphen key, which will not tag the info as a list. To fix this, select the Home tab, highlight the entire list, and choose which style of bullet points you want from the paragraph box. Columns can be achieved by using the Tab key to separate sentences. Not only is this detrimental to screen readers, it is trickier to format for yourself as well. Instead, use the built-in column tool that Word provides. These two columns have been set up with the Tab key. So to fix this, first I'll need to copy and paste my content to separate paragraphs. Once you have two paragraphs, to turn them into columns, highlight the desired text, select the Layout tab, click on Columns, and choose the desired number. Screen readers will now be able to read the information in the correct order, and you'll also find it much easier to change this information if needed. Setting up tables correctly will help screen readers correctly identify the headers in the columns and rows. In the table we're looking at now, the headers in the first row and the first column have been entered just like the data itself. With the table complete, we can make this information more accessible in just a few steps. First, left-click into one of the cells of the table. Select Design from the top ribbon. In the top left are checkboxes for tagging headers. My table has headers in the first row and column, so I need to check Header Row and First Column. Next, select the Layout tab, highlight your entire header row, and click on Repeat Header Rows. Lastly, in the Table Styles section, change the appearance of the table so the headers are clearly identified from the rest of the data. When it comes to hyperlinks, if you just copy and paste a full URL into your document, then a screen reader will read out every single character of that URL. By using descriptive hyperlinks, we can convey more relevant information on what the link will provide. An added benefit is the document will look much more professional. For a more descriptive hyperlink, we're going to reword this sentence as, "For more information on the branches of the US government, please visit the Truman Library website." and make Truman Library website the hyperlink. Microsoft Word has a built-in accessibility checker that will scan your document for potential issues and show you a summary. To run the accessibility checker, select File in the top ribbon, click on Check for Issues, and select Check Accessibility. On the right side will be a list of any issues and why those are issues. Click on any issues listed to see where they're located in your document so you may correct them. There are a couple of accessibility issues that the accessibility checker will not be able to detect. Any text that you wanted to make a header but typed as regular text, and no title for the document. The accessibility checker may also give a false issue of alternative text for tables being missing. As long as you formatted the headers and rows as shown earlier in this video, your table will be okay. If you're unsure on how to fix an issue, when you select an issue, in the bottom right of the summary will be step-by-step instructions on how to correct it. Exporting your document as a PDF following one of these steps will ensure your accessibility tags carry over to Adobe. Before beginning to export the PDF, check that you have the correct application settings enabled. Select the Acrobat tab in the top ribbon, click on Preferences, and make sure that the Enable Accessibility and Reflow with Tagged Adobe PDF setting is checked. To export, select the Acrobat tab and click Create PDF. You can also select File and click Save as Adobe PDF. Lastly, you can select File, click Save As, and change the file type to PDF. Click on Options, and make sure that Document Structure Tags for Accessibility is checked. If you liked the information presented in today's video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can get notified when we post additional videos.